topic for free paper presentation is defects there on contrast sensitivity subjects implanted with trifocal IOLs. Me or any other authors don't have any financial disclosure to make. Multifocal IOLs such as extended depth of focus or trifocal IOLs are good options to manage pseudophakic presbyopia. Implantation of multifocal IOL has positive impact on patient's quality of life postoperatively, with improved visual outcomes and quality of life index. Previous studies have reported that trifocal IOL designs provide good near, intermediate, and distance visual performances and increased spectacle independence as compared to bifocal or the traditional multifocal IOLs. Many of the patients implanted with multifocal IOLs complain of photic phenomena such as halos and glare. Glare is a condition where which affects contrast sensitivity in both mesopic as well as photopic conditions, and thus may affect the quality of life for daily activities like driving. So we plan to evaluate the effect of glare on contrast sensitivity in eyes implanted with trifocal IOL. It was a prospective study. Subjects who were implanted with trifocal IOL, aqueous of IQ Panoptics or a trifocal IOL by care group were included in the study. There were 66 eyes with Panoptics IOL implantation and 85 eyes with trifocal IOL implantation included for the study. The mean age in the Panoptics group was 58.79 years and was in trifocal group 54.45 years. So inclusion criteria included subjects implanted with trifocal IOL, subjects aged between 40 to 70 years, and best corrected post-operative 1 month visual acuity of better than 0.2 log margins. Exclusion criteria included pre-op corneal astigmatism of more than 0.75 diopters, IOP of more than 22 millimeters of mercury, any other ocular comorbidities, intra or post-operative complications, cases where swept source optical biometry was not possible, and patients who lost the follow-up before 1 month. So contrast assessment was done with the help of instrument CSV-1000HGT, which uses halogen glare source. Here we evaluated the contrast using four different spatial frequencies, 3, 6, 12, and 18, which can be seen in the diagram as A, B, C, and D, respectively. The contrast was checked with as well as without the source of glare, and glare actually is automatically calibrated by the machine and with the help of the numbers graded here 1 to 8, whatever point patient is not able to differentiate between the plane and the graded card, that is the point which is taken as the contrast sensitivity function. So this is the line diagram which is showing the contrast sensitivity with and without the glare in both Panoptics as well as the trifocal group. Here in this line diagram with the Panoptics, we can see the contrast sensitivity with glare is reduced at the spatial frequency of 3, 6, 12, and 18. Although the statistical significance was not there for the frequencies of 12 and 18, in trifocal group, the contrast sensitivity function was reduced at all the frequencies. So as I already mentioned, the contrast sensitivity was in the Panoptics group was mainly reduced at the spatial frequency of 3 and 6, whereas in trifocal group, it was reduced at all the frequencies.
So coming to the discussion part, the contrast sensitivity function is more complete performance related measure of the functional quality of vision. We use CSV-HGT machine, which is a reliable and common tool in clinical practice to evaluate the effect of glare on contrast sensitivity. In the present study, we observed that contrast sensitivity function with or without glare in eyes with trifocal IOLs followed actually a similar pattern which was studied in previous studies for normal objects or eyes that are implanted with monofocal IOLs. This pattern is basically a classic low spatial frequency roll-off at 3 CPD, that is at 3 spatial frequency, the contrast sensitivity dips, and again it picks up at the 6 CPD, followed by a dip at the spatial frequency of 12 and 18, which is seen in normal patients as well as patients with monofocal IOLs, and similar pattern we have seen in trifocal IOLs also. So most of the attributed this effect of similar pattern in trifocal IOL to the trifocal designs. Most of the multifocal or trifocal IOLs have either less than 4 millimeter or more than 5 millimeter. The smaller diffractive zones result in compromised intermediate or near vision performance in low light conditions, and large diffractive zones result in compromised distance vision in mesopic conditions. Panoptics IOL has a diffractive zone of 4.5 millimeter, which is a less pupil dependent diameter, and it is not much dependent on light condition, unlike the previous multifocal IOL. This could be one of the reasons that we did not find much effect of glare on contrast sensitivity in eyes implanted with panoptics IOL. The contrast sensitivity was reduced at all spatial frequency in eyes implanted with triphobic IOL. This could be attributed to the design of the IOL. Conclude, overall, even though contrast sensitivity was found to be reduced in presence of glare in panoptics and triphobic groups, it was significant and was comparable to contrast sensitive function of in previous studies. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
So we can
go question for the
question and answers, yes, from the judges.
You have your next paper as well. You can go to your next paper then. Ashu, you have any question?
No, I would just like to say that very interesting study. And so effectively, if you were to summarize, there was a difference in the IOL performance.
Yes, sir.
And but do you think it's significant enough or not?
Sir, clinically, when we actually inquired with the questionnaire to the patient regarding the clinical or day-to-day life, it was not significant. But statistically, it was significant.
At two spatial frequencies,
yeah,
it was.
Yeah.
Three and six. Yeah. But in real-life terms, it probably does not impact much.
Yes.
Well, that's good to know. I think you can start with.